There are billions of complex chemical reactions that happen within your body. Most of them are so complex that they need help to happen at all, and they get this help from enzymes. Enzymes are proteins. Proteins are complex biological molecules that carry out nearly all the functions of a cell. There is a huge universe of proteins that function in your body. And if you take into account the world as a whole, there's even more. Enzymes are one category of proteins. But there are lots of proteins which aren't enzymes. One way to recognize an enzyme is to look at the name of the protein. If the name ends in A-S-E or A's, it's an enzyme. Like lipase, hydrogenase, amylase. These are all enzymes. To be a bit more specific, enzymes are proteins that act as catalysts. A catalyst is just a term for a substance that speeds up a reaction. This graph shows the effect enzymes have on the speed of a reaction. As you add more of an enzyme, the reaction rate goes up. This diagram shows how enzymes act. The molecule an enzyme acts on is its substrate. The substrate fits into the active site of an enzyme like a key in a lock. The active site is a very specific lock. It will only take just the right, exact substrate. That's why you need a different enzyme for each chemical reaction. Once the substrate sits in the active site, the enzyme holds the substrate, or substrates, in just the right position for a reaction to occur. In this diagram, we're looking at a reaction that breaks a chemical bond. So the enzyme holds the substrate in such a way that the chemical bond, right there, see where these two halves are joined, this chemical bond is stressed, and in an instant, it breaks. Now you have two products released from the enzyme. Sometimes you have enzymes that help make a new chemical bond. If this is what's happening, you have two substrates binding to the active site. The enzyme holds them in just the right way so that they can join together, and they're released as a single product. Many enzymes are not active just by themselves. They need helpers, other molecules, or ions that attach to the enzyme and help it bind substrate. Coenzymes are organic molecules that help enzymes function. Coenzymes often incorporate vitamins into their structure, like the B vitamins that make a part of various coenzymes involved in making ATP. Cofactors are inorganic ions that help enzymes function. Several of the minerals we need in our diet act as cofactors for important enzymes, copper, zinc, magnesium. Without coenzymes or cofactors, the enzyme is inactive. It can't function. But with its helpers, the enzyme is active. It's ready to go bind some substrate and get a reaction started. I want to mention that enzyme is a generic term. You have enzymes in every single one of your cells, and they carry out a very diverse set of reactions. There are enzymes involved in muscle contraction, making new cells, blood clotting, the activities of your brain, enzymes involved in making and using energy, even enzymes that help make other enzymes. However, the enzymes we'll be talking about the most in this class are the enzymes involved in digestion, the digestive enzymes. Digestive enzymes catalyze reactions that take large molecules in your food and break them down into small molecules that can be absorbed into your body and actually used by your cells.